Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the fifth and last part of my Great Wall Hobby 1/48 scale Mig-29 Fulcrum build. So last time, I fixed all the decals in place and then gave the kit another coat of gloss varnish. Once the varnish dried, it was time to give the kit a wash. I used Tamiya's black panel line accent color. I start with one wing, just to see how the wash looks. Once the wash was dry, I wiped away all the extra wash with a Q-tip moistened with odorless spirit. As you can see, the wash really brings out the panel lines and the rivets. Initially, I was going to give the kit a pin wash. That is, I would only apply the wash in the panel lines and the rivets. But as I moved on, I realized that the entire surface was full of rivets and panel lines, and so I might as well give the entire kit a wash. Some of the panel lines on the fuselage top appear to be too shallow to hold a wash properly. Now personally, I like this randomness in the wash. But if you like an even wash over all the features, then you may want to deepen these panel lines before painting the kit. For the anti-glare panel, I am using a grey wash. Now for the trickiest part of the weathering process, post-shading. Earlier, I used to thin down regular black paint for post-shading. However, nowadays, I use Tamiya's X19 smoke, which is just as good and much easier to apply. I keep a Q-tip handy. In case I feel I have overdone the post-shading or I accidentally splatter too much paint, I quickly wipe it away. The key is to move quickly, and one can simply wipe away the mistakes. Once I was done with the weathering on the top, I flipped the kit over and repeated the process, starting with the wash. Next, some post shading. I now cut and clean and glue together the landing gear assemblies. The gear is fairly well detailed. I dry fit the parts of the nose landing gear. There are two parts. Once they are in place, I glue them together. Gluing the parts together like this ensures that I don't have fit issues later when it comes time to glue the landing gear to the fuselage. Now the main landing assembly. And here I ran into a problem. The landing gear does not really fit. It would appear that the way the landing gear is designed, it would have been best to try and glue it in place when I was assembling the wheel wells. Anyway, the only way out now is to cut and trim the landing gear and force it in place. Another slight problem with the kit is the large number of sink marks in the smaller parts, like the wheel well covers. These needed to be filled and sanded. To keep the paint job same as that on the fuselage, I first gave all the parts a black base. I had planned to keep the air brakes in open position, but look at the number of sink marks. Not only that, they are placed right on top of the fragile details. I was in no mood to spend the next 2 days cleaning up these marks, so I had to close the air brakes. Pity. Next, all the parts were painted with Compass Ghost Grey. Once the paint was dry, I applied a gloss varnish on all the parts. And then, once that was dry, I gave the parts a wash. The metallic parts were painted with Molotow liquid chrome. Once everything was nice and dry, I glued all the parts in place. I now cut and cleaned the hard points and the weapons load. One brilliant feature of the kit are the various missiles it comes with. The quality of these slide molded weapons is excellent. I decided to paint the parts of the weapons load assembly on the sprue itself. Handling missiles is very difficult once they are cut off the sprue. I start by spraying the parts with a primer. Next, the missiles were painted with white. Some of the missiles needed to be masked and painted further. I now have to mask the canopy to paint what I believe is the pressure seal. Once again, I use a narrow masking tape for the job. Now, usually the seal is pink, but the instructions stated that I paint it ivory white. So I looked around the internet and found that while these seals were usually pink, there were a few off-white and white variants too. I went with the white. finally the moment of truth, unmasking the canopy. Not bad. There seems to be a little paint on the canopy, but this was easily removed with a cocktail stick. Right then, fellow model makers. Here is my take on the Great Wall Hobby 1/48 scale Mig-29 Fulcrum. I hope you enjoyed this video series. Please do leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till next time, good luck and happy model making.